My presentation is ancient traditional Georgian weeds, diversity, conservation, and endemic taxa with focus on health and nutrition. Georgia is a very small country. It's situated between Black and Caspian Sea, very close to nearest. Territory of Georgia is only 70,000 square kilometers. 15 species of wheat found in Georgia from 25 worldwide. All genomes what are in genus triticum, all genomes represent in Georgia. This is diploid species, tetraploid AABB genome, tetraploid AAG genome, hexaploid AAGGAA genome, and hexaploid AABBDD genome. Two genomes, AAGG and AAGGAA, are represented only in Georgia, and you cannot find domesticated weeds with this genome any other places. All genomes, diploid acorn, both groups of tetraploid wheat, and both groups of hexaploid wheat are represented in Georgia. This hexaploid wheat, AABBD genome, this is bread wheat. D genome is comes from Aegilops tauschii. Aegilops tauschii, you can see intraspecific variation in Aegilops tauschii. There are two subspecies, Aegilops tauschii subspecies tauschii with two haplogroups, and Aegilops tauschii subspecies triangulata again with two haplogroups. Donor of D genome is subspecies strangulata. Subspecies tauschii is not donor of D genome, only subspecies strangulata. This subspecies strangulata represented with two haplogroups, haplogroup 9 and haplogroup 17. Haplogroup 17, donor of the genome with both haplogroups, represented in Georgia. Here is map of distribution of Aegilops tauschii subspecies and genomes in the worldwide. This work is from a Japanese scientist, Takumi. And here you can see with bright blue and dark blue color, it is subspecies strangulata, the D genome donor. And another yellow and green color, this is two haplogroups from subspecies tauschii. So haplogroup 17, this one haplogroup, found only in Georgia. Again, common wheat was derived from single or limited accessions of tauschii and Aegilops tauschii population far from its birthplace were not involved in the formation of common wheat, indicated Takumi in his work, in his paper. This is another Japanese scientist's paper from Matsuoka's investigation. He studied distribution of Aegilops tauci accessions by flowering time. He indicated that first originated, first ancient tauci was late flowering. You can see it's in blue color. And the evolution of Aegilops tauci goes through intermediated flowering to early flowering. So early flowering is more late origin. All this is late flowering in blue color. In the Caucasus, you can see two haplogroups. Haplogroup haplogroup 7 and haplogroup 16. These two haplogroups are from Aegilops tauci, subspecies tauci, which is not donor of the genome. Also represented in Caucasus, and another haplogroup, this is haplogroup 9, it's a triangle, and haplogroup 17, it's asterisk. This is represented again in the Caucasus, and haplogroup 17 only in Georgia. So Aegilops tauci evolved from late flowering to early flowering. The ancient late flowering forms of both subspecies tauci and subspecies strangulata are marked in blue color and are found only in Caucasus. You can see blue. And the distribution area of tauci expanded through eastwards and southwards dispersal. Aegilops tauci, subspecies strangulata, took longer to evolve from the late flowering in blue color, you can see, to medium flowering. So this subspecies strangulata also grows in the south of Caspian Sea, but it's in green color, it's late origin. The early origin is in blue color. So the ancient late flowering subspecies strangulata crossed the tetraploid parent of the bread wheat. So bread wheat can originate it only in the place where grows tetraploid ABB genome and Aegilops tauci subspecies strangulata. This is Shem from Dudnikov's article about evolution of Aegilops tauci. On the first, you can see on the first place, this is whole tauci before dividing into species. It was very ancient mutation with two blue, dark black spots. It was very ancient mutation before dividing. Then again was another, and Aegilops tauci divided into subspecies. The upper subspecies, this is subspecies strangulata, and another is subspecies tauci. So Aegilops tauci divided in two subspecies, tauci and strangulata, and as indicated Dudnikov, Agilopstauchi originated in the Caucasus, because this all accessions with all the mutation, it's found in the territory of Caucasus and in Georgia. And Dudnikov also indicated that in contrast to subspecies Tauchi, geographic spread of subspecies Strangulata was very complicated, multi-stage, and very slow process. The Caucasus is the only region where all the five subspecies Strangulata lineages were found, says Dudnikov. I mentioned that in Georgia there are 15 species of wheat. Five of them are endemics to Georgia. Here is endemic Georgian species. Monococcum is not, but there are some subspecies, local endemics, but all other five species, Triticum timofeevi, in Georgian it's called Celta zanduri, Triticum zhukovski zanduri, Triticum paleocolchicum asli, Triticum cartlicum dica, and Triticum maha. These all five species are endemics to Georgia. From these five endemic species, four species are huldweeds. Totally in Georgia, we have seven species of huldweeds. Four of them are endemics and three are non-endemic species. Four endemic species from five found only in province Lechkumi. This is Georgia. I mentioned that Georgia is a small country, and there is a very small province, Lechkumi, where four species of wheat originated. This is Lechkumi. This is mountain region. In the past, in these mountain slopes grow these four species up to 20th century, up to 70s, 80s of 20th century. In these places, it was wheat fields. Russian botanist Sinskaya, she was colleague of Vavilov, she mentioned that Front Asia is native place of 12 wheat endemic species. Eight of them originated from Transcaucasus. From endemic species of Transcaucasus, five species originated from Georgia. And Georgia occupies the first place with richness in wheat species and forms on the edge, mentioned Sinskaya. Archaeologist Nesbitt also indicated that in Transcaucasus, a fascinating variety of huldweeds is grown. Huldweeds, there are all these ancient forms of wheat. And he mentioned that huldweeds grown is in Transcaucasus, many huld species, and the same diversity is found in ancient plant remains, in archaeological excavations also. There is an archaeological site, Aruchlo. It's 8,000 years before present, 6th millennia BC. In Aruchlo, eight species of wheat was found. Among these eight, four species, Triticum spelta, Triticum compactum, Triticum estivum, and Triticum spherococcum, all are hexaploid with the earliest appearance of naked tetraploid wheats, also Triticum cartlicum and Triticum durum, is in the oldest layers in a ruchlo. Quantity presence of free threshing wheat species, Triticum estivum, is evident. Percentage of this soft wheats is 50-75% of all wheat population found in this Aruchlo in 8,000 years ago. So 8,000 years ago, people had free threshing estivum wheat, but they still continue to sow these hulled wheats, what are very hard to thresh. In another site, also in archaeological site in Shulaveri and Hramis Didigora, also the same period, 9 species of domesticated wheats were found. These species all found in Shulaveri were found with together with barley, oat, rye, and millet. Shulaveri, the place where found the oldest domesticated grape peeps and fermented wine. And in these layers with grape peeps were found also seeds of Triticum. According to UNESCO, it's Georgia was accepted as homeland of winemaking and viticulture. Carbon dating shows that these layers where was found these seeds, grinds, indicates that more than 8,000 years before present. As indicated, Hammond, Ziguri, and other scientists, comparisons between Shulaveri Shom complex and contemporary Halaf and Hasusana cultures in North Mesopotamia and Hasilar in Anatolia shows that cereals cultivated in Transcaucasus are much more diverse than in Anatolia and in Mesopotamia, mentioned Hammond. There was, as I know, only 2 or 3 species of domesticated wheat. Here is 8 and 9 species. Yes, yes. Not only domesticated, endemic species. Also in Georgia, we have many non-endemic species with many varieties. You can see Turgidum compactum, and the last is Triticum estivum, which was represented in Georgia by 48 varieties up to nowadays. This is American scientist Bikram Jill's paper article where he showed on the, you can see on the left side there are wild species and on the right side are domesticated species. Here you can see these 3 species, Triticum timofevi, Triticum monococcum, and Triticum zhukovski. It's in Georgia always grows 3 species together, and Georgian farmers call it Zanduri population, Zanduri Landraces. This is all found only in Georgia, especially, mentioned that Timofevi and Zhukovsky, these species are endemics to Georgia. Okay. Also, Triticum cartilicum, also found. Here is endemic species. This is Timofevi, this is Zhukovsky, Paleogolchicum, this is Macha, which one species represented with many varieties inside. And as a conclusion, Georgia is one of most important centers of diversity of the domesticated wheat. Georgian wheat species constitute a special living museum where the whole diversity of wheat genus Triticum is presented. The great variety of endemic wheat species in Transcaucasus could have favored the local domestication of cereals, even if these cereals were already cultivated in Near East and then bring to Caucasus. So in Georgia, we have also very oldest ancient tools for collecting this endemic wheat species. This is another species also endemic to Georgia, but it's not hulled wheat. It is free threshing wheat, Triticum cartulicum. Sometimes this name people are say as Triticum persicum, but it's not correct name, Triticum persicum for this wheat. According to botanical nomenclatural code, the correct name of this species is Triticum cartulicum. This is wheat landraces, Triticum estivum. Landrace, Achalcichis citelli doli red doli, which is famous with its nutrition and very healthy food. As a conclusion again, Georgian endemic species and the landraces are distinguished by resistance to fungal diseases as well as drought and frost resistance. These endemic species are distinguished by their ability to grow in all kinds of soils, even in limestone. They are distinguished by high protein content in grains and high lysine content in protein. And soft wheats variety, Achalcichis red doli landraces, are distinguished by easy maturity, easy threshing, resistance to fluttering and grain shedding. Bread baked from flour of Georgian endemic species and landraces is white, tasty, flavorful, and maintain softness to several days. And finally, as a conclusion, grains of the endemic Georgian wheat species is distinguished by high nutritional quality. Endemic Georgian wheat species contain precious genes which are important for wheat improvement. Thank you for your attention.